So for those of you that are watching my channel, know that I've been dabbling with the MacBook for the past few months. I've been a predominantly PC user for the majority of my life, and right now I want to test out the other end of the spectrum. And I have to say, it's been very enjoyable. And there's a bunch of stuff on the Mac side of things that I like better than I do on Windows. Now this video is not so much about a Mac versus PC type of stuff. This is just more about the tool that you're using. These are just tools at the end of the day. They both will get you the same result. It's just which one you enjoy using more while you do it. Now, before I get to what I like better, I just want to give a quick shout out to a sponsor of this video. Intego has been keeping Mac safe since 1997, so it's no surprise that they're the leader in Mac security. Intego's Mac Internet Security X9 has the two critical tools you need to keep your Mac safe, secure, and protected from the internet threats. It includes Virus Barrier, the world's number one best Mac antivirus, which blocks all varieties of adware and malware from infecting your Mac. Mac malware has been on the rise lately. In June alone, Intego discovered and was the first to protect against several new threats. For example, Crescent Core, which spreads via download links and even perfectly innocent Google searches, anyone could get bitten by it, and since Intego discover it, they have the best protection. Bundled with Virus Barrier is Net Barrier, a two-way firewall that not only prevents incoming attacks on your network, it can also alert you when apps on your Mac try to phone home and potentially violate your privacy. So click on the link in the video description to protect your Mac from hackers and malware, and if you buy today, you'll save 60%. So the first thing is Media Preview. This is one thing I discovered immediately and I was like, wow, I have been missing this the entire time. When you import footage onto the Mac, it doesn't matter if it's a picture or a video, you can see a preview of it in the thumbnail. This is so clutch, especially if you're a video creator like myself, you can see the thumbnail of the video of a portion of it to get an understanding of what you're importing. On the PC, this only works with specific types of files. It might work with a JPEG, but it doesn't work with ProRes. You have to import it into the program first to see exactly what you're looking at. This is great for video editors because if I plug in an external hard drive, I can select the exact files I want to copy over as opposed to copying everything over, bringing it into the program itself, and then selecting the files I want to keep. So the second thing is AirDrop, and I'll be honest with you, I don't use it that often. And the reason I don't use it is because I'm so hardwired as a PC user, because I've been so used to just basically uploading my files to the cloud, like Google Drive, and then downloading them on my computer, or at least waiting for them to sync up. And that's how I've been doing it for years. But every time I do make a mental note to remember to use AirDrop, I wish Windows had the same feature, because quite frankly, it is so convenient and so much quicker to send a file from your phone or your iPad directly to your Mac computer via AirDrop. This is a direct connection using their protocol, and it just makes transferring that file quicker than waiting for it to go up to the internet and then come back down, especially if you're like transferring bigger files. The next feature is technically not out yet. It's still in beta, but it's called Sidecar, and it's coming out with macOS Catalina sometime in the fall. The beauty about Sidecar is it allows you to utilize the screen real estate on your iPad. You can do this right now if you buy a hardware dongle from a company called Luna, but you have to remember to carry it with you, and it requires you to purchase that piece of extra hardware. Sidecar is free. If you have an iPad, you can use it automatically because it's baked into macOS, and it just works very, very well. It doesn't matter if you have a USB Type-C cable with you, as long as you have a Wi-Fi connection, the second display is used on your iPad. With Windows laptops, as soon as you unplug it from a wall, it begins to power throttle in order to conserve battery and to protect the battery from any damage, especially if it has a dedicated GPU, and it doesn't matter if you increase the power and performance settings in Windows 10. I didn't realize that the Mac Pro does something a bit different. If you unplug it from the wall, it continues to perform exactly as if it was plugged in. You're gonna get the exact same performance. And this is absolutely amazing because Apple is maybe using like a weaker GPU, but those GPUs inside of these laptops have lower TDPs. Therefore, it's not gonna damage the battery, and it allows you to take advantage of the entire laptop. And finally, it's optimizations. And this is something we all know about. Macs just work better because the software and hardware is closed, so it's able to speak better to each other. And I've noticed this in tons of applications. Even Adobe Premiere, which is available on both PC and laptop. Right now, today, the experience is smoother on a Mac, even with hardware that is weaker than more powerful Windows laptops. Adobe, Apple have all gotten together to optimize the MacBook to become a better experience. This holds true with Apple-related apps like Final Cut Pro and Logic. If you use these programs on the Mac, they're gonna run better in comparison to something that's equivalent on a PC. So those are some of the things that I discovered about the Mac that I really like, that I really wish Windows had. Now, obviously the Mac is not perfect and I can make an entire another video of what the PC does better, but this is what I discovered on my journey on using the MacBook Pro. Anyways, that wraps up this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it, got some insight into the other side, because if you did, I'd love if you hit the like button. If you're new to the channel, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.